فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد آخر الأنبياء في الدنيا عصرا وأجلهم يوم القيامة شأنا وذكرا، صلى الله وملائكته والصالحون من خلقه كما وحد الله وعرف به ودعا إليه. أما بعد، كتاب الصيام وإنه كتاب بلوغ المرام من أدلة الأحكام للإمام الحافظ ابن حجر العسقلاني رحمه الله. We're going to take the chapter of fasting as we promised. The first hadith in which Al-Imam Ibn Hajar Al-Asqalani rahimahullah, he starts the chapter of fasting with is the hadith of Abu Hurairah. The hadith of Abu Hurairah. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تقدموا رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين إلا رجل كان يصوم يوما فليصمه. متفق عليه. The first hadith is the hadith narrated by Abu Huraira. The hadith is narrated by who? Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Abu Huraira said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تقدموا رمضان بصوم يوم. Do not precede Ramadan a day before it. ولا يومين, neither two days. إلا رجل, except a person. كان يصوم صوما, except a person who used to fast a fasting. فليصومه, let that person fast their fasting. متفق عليه. This hadith is narrated by Imam al-Bukhari and Imam Muslim. So this hadith, the Prophet ﷺ is saying that no one should fast a day before Ramadan or 2 days before Ramadan unless you used to fast before, then you can fast, no problem. The hadith we promised last lesson, the way we're going to discuss this hadith is in this way. Al-kalamu ala al-hadithi riwayatan. We're going to be speaking about the hadith in terms of its riwayah, its chain of narration, and the science of it related to it. So this hadith, Bukhari and Muslim, both of them have narrated it. And they all narrated it from Abu Hurairah, both of them. And the chain revolves around وَمَدَارُ أَسَانِيدِهِ. And all of the chain revolves around Yahya ibn Abi Kathir, who narrated from Abi Salamah, who then narrated from Abu Hurairah. So if Bukhari and Muslim both narrated this hadith, and they all narrated it from Abu Hurairah, and their chain revolves around Yahya ibn Abi Kathir, Abi Salamah, Abi Hurairah. Point number two. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he mentioned this hadith mu'allaqan. Mu'allaqan means when Bukhari does not mention his teacher. Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, he mentioned this hadith mu'allaqan, without mentioning his sheikh, in the chapter of fasting, or in the book of fasting, under the chapter, هل يقال رمضان أو شهر رمضان. Bukhari brought it under the chapter of what? Should we say Ramadan or should we say the month of Ramadan? هل يقال رمضان? Should we say Ramadan or شهر رمضان? ومن رأى كله واسعا, and whoever sees the matter to be open for everyone. Meaning whoever sees it to be what? Permissible to say each and every, whichever one. And then straight away, instead of bringing a chain, Bukhari didn't do it because he brought it mu'allaqan. So what did he do? He said, قَالَ وَقَالَ النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ لَا تَقَدَّمُوا رَمَضَانَ. What did he do, Bukhari rahimahullah? He brought it, that hadith in the chapter. So he didn't mention no chain for it. And he brought it under what chapter? He brought it in the book of fasting, but which chapter? He brought it in the chapter of, should we say Ramadan or the month of Ramadan? And whoever sees the issue to be open, whichever one you can take, if you want. And then straight away he brought this, he said what? That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not fast before Ramadan. So what is Imam Bukhari trying to get with it? And we're going to be tackling it a bit more later. Bukhari is trying to get with it now here, is the permissibility of say Ramadan or the month of Ramadan. And we're going to be speaking about that later inshallah ta'ala. The third point that we take from it in terms of riwayah is Imam Muslim, he mentions this hadith in his fasting, in the book of fasting, Kitab al-Siyam. Okay? And the chaptering that it was put under, لَا تَقَدَّمُ رَمَضَانَ بِصَوْمِ يَوْمٍ وَلَا يَوْمَيْنِ. The chaptering is exactly the wording of the hadith. Do not fast a day or 2 days before Ramadan. Point number four. Bukhari rahimahullah, there is a narration in his Sahih which he brought the wording for it and he brought the chain for it. He brought it with the chain of narration for it is لا يتقدمن أحدكم رمضان بصوم يوم أو يومين إلا أن يكون رجل كان يصوم صوما فليصم ذلك اليوم. Those wordings, which the meaning is the same, but the wording being different, he brought that wording, but he brought it what? With his chain of narration from himself to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the other one, by the way, لا تقدم رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين إلا رجل كان يصوم يوما فليصم. Don't think to yourself that Bukhari didn't bring it with his chain as well. He did. Even though he brought it under the chaptering, he also did bring it in his Sahih with his chain. The other point that we can take from that, the other point regarding the narration and the hadith is, the wording in this hadith here, the wording of the hadith here that Imam Hafiz ibn Hajar brought in his Bulugh, the wording here is the wording of Imam Muslim. Okay, so if it was the wording of Muslim, فَكَانَ الْأَوْلَى بِالْحَافِظِ, it would have been more right, befitting for Imam Hafiz ibn Hajar أَنْ يُشِيرَ إِلَى ذَلِكَ, to point that out for us. كَمَا فَعَلَ Ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid, like Ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid did in his Kitab al-Imam. And also Ibn Abdul Hadi did in his Kitab al-Muharrar. They pointed it out that the wording of this hadith that we're studying today is the wording of Imam Muslim. They pointed it out. Whereas Hafiz ibn Hajar, he did not. Also, by the way, this hadith, the six books, it's narrated in the six books, Ummahatu Sitta, Kutub Sitta, they narrated it. And when I say the six books, which six books am I referring to? The Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim, and the four Sunan in Arba'ah, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah, and Nasa'i. They all narrated it, six, right? And also Ahmad narrated it. And Imam Ahmad also narrated it. So according to the istilah of Hafiz ibn Hajar, according to the terminology that Hafiz ibn Hajar, he mentions in Bulugh al-Maram that he's going to use, if the two Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim, and the four Sunan, Abu Dawud, Tirmidhi, Ibn Majah and Nasa'i, and Ahmad, if they all narrated, what's it called? Rawahu Sab'a. The seven, right? He should have said narrated by the seven. But the reason why he didn't, he also told us in the Muqaddimah, if you guys remember very well. He said, if the hadith is specifically, is narrated in Bukhari and Muslim, he said, ألا يذكر مع الشيخين غيرهما. With Sahihain Bukhari and Muslim, he's not going to mention any other chain that is there. Why? Because the reality is that Bukhari and Muslim was in there, there's no need to us to mention other places that are in. They suffice us from it, right? And as the scholars, they say, فَلَا مُشَاحَةَ فِي الْإِصْطِلَاحِ. There shouldn't be no argument when it comes to those terminologies, inshaAllah ta'ala. Now we finished talking about the hadith in terms of its sciences that are pertaining to it, which is slightly the hardest thing when it comes to studying each hadith. We're now going to move on to, we're going to now talk about al-kalamu ala al-hadith diraya. We're going to be speaking about the hadith in terms of the rulings and the things that we can take from the hadith. Before I mention that, I would have to mention a grammatical benefit that can be taken out of this hadith. A grammatical benefit. Those of you who focus on grammar who love grammar. The hadith mentions, لَا تَقَدَّمُوا رَمَضَانَ بِصَوْمِ يَوْمٍ وَلَا يَوْمَيْنِ إِلَّا رَجُلٌ except a man. So it's here, what does it say? إِلَّا رَجُلٌ. The last letter on the word رَجُل is a what? What's the letter called at the ending? رَجُلٌ. What's it? It's a lamb, right? The last letter in the word رَجُل is a lamb, right? Good. What's on top of the lamb? There's a raf' on there. We have to be more, when we speak, we have to be more with grammar. So, إِلَّا رَجُلٌ. We have a raf'. We have a marfu' on top of it, a raf'. And we know raf'. Is more comprehensive than dhamma. Because raf', how many does it occur in? Four, right? Al-dhammu, wal-waw, wal-alif, wal-nunu. Sah? Very good. إِلَّا رَجُلٌ. We have it raf'. That's how Imam al-Hafidh ibn Hajar mentions it in his Bulugh al-Maram. So you say, إِلَّا رَجُلٌ. Raf. This is a raf. Good. And if you look at all of the nusakh of Sahih Muslim, even the one that was published by Daru Ta'seel, which is the latest publication of Sahih Muslim, all of the nusakhs I looked into, التي وقفت عليها, in which I stood over, all of them, they mention what? إِلَّا رَجُلٌ. That's one point. So because the wording is, which wording? The wording of which hadith is this? It's the wording of Imam Muslim. صح? So we have to look at all of the narrations of Muslim. They all mention what? إلا رجل. إلا رجلون. إلا رجلون. صح? But this is one of the places that it is permissible في نصب المستثنى. You are allowed to say رجلون ورفعه ونصبه is permissible. And you could say وإلا رجلا. It's both. But the raf' is afsah, is more eloquent. When you say illa rajul, is more eloquent. And it shows more strength in the language. And the qa'idah is, إِذَا وَقَعَ الْمُسْتَثْنَى بَعْدَ الْمُسْتَثْنَى مِنْهُ. If the mustathna here is what? Rajul, right? If it falls straight after, إذا وقع المستثنى, if the مستثنى, it falls after the مستثنى منه في كلام, with a sentence that is complete and that is a negation. For instance, if you say ما جاء القوم إلا سليما, ما جاء القوم, what do we have here? We have the negation here. Are you with me? مَا جَاءَ الْقَوْمُ. The people did not come. Is there not negation?
No.
Is that sentence complete?
No.
It's complete. So it's a negation. مَا جَاءَ. No one came from the people. مَا جَاءَ الْقَوْمُ. The people did not come. That sentence is complete. It's a negation. And the مُسْتَثْنَى مِنْهُ, the thing that's being negated, is the coming, right? Are you with me? Are you with me? That's what's been negated. The mustathna is what? illa Saliman, right? Saliman fell after what? After the mustathna minhu, which is what? ما جاء القوم إلا ما جاء القوم. In this situation, it is permissible to say ما جاء القوم إلا سليما or سليم. Because the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, if you look at it, it says لا تقدم رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين. The مستثنى منه. First of all, the sentence is a كلام تام منفي وقع المستثنى بعد المستثنى منه. إلا رجل fell after what? After the مستثنى منه, which is what? لا تقدموا رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين. That's in terms of Arabic. So what is it going to be when it is a منصوب? What's the grammatical analysis for it? And then when it is رفع, what's the grammatical analysis for it? If it's منصوب, then it's استثناء, and استثناء is always مرفوع. The مستثنى is مرفوع. منصوب. Or when it's مرفوع, it's a بدل من المستثنى منه. It's a بدل. بدل of what? مستثنى منه, which is لا تقدموا رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين. مستثنى منه. And so then it's a مستثنى منه. فرجل, the word رجل is a what? It's a بدل بعض من كل. And this is well known and studied in the books of grammar. We spoke about that when we studied أجرمية. That's the grammatical analysis of it. Let's now go into the fiqh of the hadith. The fiqh that we take from the hadith, number one. The fiqh that we take from this hadith is, what is the ruling in fasting a day or even 2 days before Ramadan? What's the ruling? The first question is, what is the ruling in fasting a day or two before Ramadan? If we look at the zahir of the hadith, if we look at from the apparent of the hadith, if we look at it from its apparent, it's a negation. ظاهر النهي, it's prohibited. If we look at the hadith, because the Prophet specifically said, لا تقدموا. And the word لا تقدموا shows what? Prohibition, because the Prophet is negating something from us, he's prohibiting something from us, it's haram for us to do it. إذن النهي تقتضي التحريم, right? The qa'idah is what? Prohibition, what does it necessitate? I mean, if you're told to not do something, it shows that it's prohibited from you. Sahih? And this is well known, كما هو معروف معروف في أصول الفقه. This is very well known in أصول الفقه. So if, for example, a person fast a day or two before Ramadan, is it prohibited from them?
No.
It is prohibited from them. So if it's prohibited from them, it is what? It is haram, right? They're sinning in doing so. So this necessitates sin, and it also necessitates the nullification of this action. This action is nullified now. Are you with me? Null and void. All over. Now the question that arises is, we're still at the first point when it comes to the ruling pertaining to the hadith, is, are all the scholars on the same side on this? Are they all in agreement on this? Do they all agree that the hadith here is that it is negate the nahi, and then if it's nahi, then it's haram, and if it's haram, then the person who does it mujibul lil ithmi wa butlan ila amal? Do they all agree on that? We'll say no. There's two views regarding this. There's two opinions and two views regarding it. The first opinion is wa huwa qawlu jumhur ahli al-'ilm. This is the view of the majority of the scholars. This is the opinion of the. It's the view of the majority of the scholars. What do they say? What's the view of the Jumhur? The opinion of the Jumhur is that the negation in here, it is not prohibition, rather it is disliked. So they said here, the nahi, the negation here. Are you with me? They said it is not lit-tahrimi, but it's lil-karaha. It is not haram, but it's disliked. And that is what's well known in Madhab al-Hanabila, the Hanbali Madhab. Are you with me? This is well known and it's documented in the Hanbali Madhab. So based on that opinion, فَلَوْ صَامَ قَبْلَ رَمَضَانَ. If a person fasts before Ramadan, بِيَوْمٍ a day or two, ايه if he fast a day or two before Ramadan فليس بآثم he is not a sinner وصومه مقبول and his fasting is accepted. That's the natija that comes out of it. Are you with me? Because النهي للكراهة automatically means what? That it is what? ليس بآثم, the person is not a sinner, وصومه مقبول and his fasting is accepted. Are you with me? Are you with me? Whereas of the other opinion, it would have been what? The other opinion we're going to come to now. The other opinion is the second one. It's the second opinion. Before I go into the second opinion, Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi said something which we should read, inshallah ta'ala. Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi said, the great muhaddith, he said, Al-Amalu ala hadha al-hadith, implementing this hadith. Al-Amalu ala hadha al-hadith inda ahli al-ilm, implementing this hadith, or the way that this hadith is implemented according to the people of knowledge is, Karihu an yata'ajjal al-rajul, that they dislike that a person hastens بالصيام قبل دخول شهر رمضان, that a person hastens by fasting before the entering of the month of Ramadan. With what? لمعنى الرمضان, with the thought in his mind of it being Ramadan. They dislike it. They don't say it's haram. So they're saying it is disliked for a person to hasten before the noble month of Ramadan comes in. Before the noble month of Ramadan comes in, for that person to fast with the intention of it being Ramadan, on the safe side, as some would say. We'll speak about that later, inshallah ta'ala. But they said, وَإِن كَانَ رَجُلُ يَصُومُ صَوْمًا فَوَافَقَ صِيَامُ ذَلِكَ فَلَا بَأْسَ بِهِ عِنْدَهُمْ. But if the person used to fast and he was known to fast, a fasting, and his fasting somehow it hit a day before Ramadan or two, then they say there's no harm in that. That's the first opinion. And the statement of Imam al-Tirmidhi is finished over there. Now we move on to the next, the second opinion. We'll now move on to the second opinion. The second opinion says, أَنَّ النَّهِيَ عَلَى أَصْلِهِ, that the prohibition, we should leave it at its original essence, which is what? The original essence, the istishab of the usuliyin is what? The istishab of the usuliyin when it comes to the nahi is what?
Tahrim.
At-tahrim. The nahyu, if the sharia negates and doesn't allow you to do something, it shows prohibition. And this opinion, by the way, is madhab al-Shafi'iyya. It's the Shafi'i madhab. And also, Ibn Muflih, who wrote a book called Al-Furu', who's from the Hanbali scholars, he also took that opinion as well. And he was inclined to that opinion. And it is also the opinion held by who? It is also the opinion held by Al-Shaykh Al-Samahat Al-Walid, Al-Shaykh Abdul Aziz Ibn Abdullah Ibn Baz. That was the opinion he was more inclined to, rahimahullahu ta'ala. If you want to look more into these views and discussions even more, you can go to Sunan Al-Tirmidhi, you can go to Al-Mughni Ibn Qudama, you can go to Al-Majmu' by Imam al-Nawawi, you can go to Sharh al-Sahih Muslim by Imam al-Nawawi as well, Al-Furu' ibn Muflih, Al-Insaf lil-Marudawi, Al-Rawd al-Murbi', Majmu' al-Fatawa ibn Baz, and other places you will find more discussions regarding this particular point. Now let's move on to the second fiqh that's taken from the hadith. The second fiqh that is taken from the hadith, which is, can we say Ramadan instead of saying Shahru Ramadan? So basically, Hadful Mudaf. Can we just remove the Mudaf, which is Shahr? Can we get rid of Shahr and just bring the Mudaf on ilayh? Is it permissible? Can you do that? From the original, from the apparent of the hadith that's right in front of us that we have here, it shows the permissibility. That's what it seems like, because the Prophet specifically said Ramadan only, and he didn't say Shahru Ramadan. He said, لا تقدموا رمضان بصوم يوم ولا يومين. So, ظاهر الحديث, from the apparent, the hadith shows that it is permissible, جوازه, that it's permissible. And the meaning is going to be what? لَتَقَدَّمُوا شَهْرَ رَمَضَانِ. Are you with me? And this, of course, this hadith is in opposition, or it's not in agreement with the ayah of the Qur'an, because Allah said, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ. So if the ayah said شهر رمضان, are you with me? Then you are allowed to say, شهر رمضان, the month of Ramadan. And you can also say Ramadan because the hadith says it here. So the ayah, what did it affirm? أثبت المضاف and the مضاف إليه. Both of them it brought it. As for the hadith, it only brought the what? It only brought the مضاف إليه, it got rid of the مضاف. And that's why Bukhari, rahimahullah, it was fiqh. That's why he chaptered it. And he called it Babu, the chapter. هل يقال, should one say Ramadan or شهر رمضان? Should he say Ramadan or the month of Ramadan? Should he say that? ومن رأى كله واسعا. And whoever sees the opinion to be, both of them to be permissible. And then straight away Bukhari was trying to indicate and trying to tell the people that it's permissible to say any one of them. Because straight away he brought this hadith. Are you with me? He brought the hadith, إِذَا جَاءَ رَمَضَانَ فُتِّحَتْ أَبْوَابُ الْجَنَّةِ. If Ramadan comes, the doors of Jannah are opened. So again, the Prophet used the word Ramadan. Also, Imam al-Nasa'i, sorry. Also, Imam Abdullah al-Nasa'i, Abdul Rahman al-Nasa'i, rahimahullah, he also brought a chapter in his Sunan, قَائِلًا by saying, بَابُ الرُّخْصَةِ فِي أَنْ يُقَالَ لِشَهْرِ رَمَضَانَ رَمَضَانَ. He said, the permissibility, and that it's permitted for a person to say, or to say to the month of Ramadan, to say Ramadan to it. And then straight away, what did he bring? A hadith to support his argument. The Imam Malik's madhab, the Ashabu Malikiyah, the Malikiyah, they took the opinion that it's disliked and that one should not do it. And Ibn al-Baqillani, who's a Shafi'i, and a lot of other Shafi'iyah, they said, إِنَّ هُنَاكَ قَرِينَةٌ. They said, are you with me? Their argument is that this hadith that you guys have brought and all the other hadiths, they said there are قَرِينَة. قَرِينَة meaning there are agents or things that are in the hadith that indicate that what's been meant is Ramadan. شهر رمضان, the month of Ramadan. They said that there are indications to show that the month of Ramadan is meant here. So they said in this situation it's not disliked. But if there's no indication to show that you're referring to the month of Ramadan and you just throw the word Ramadan like that without any contextual sentences, they said in this situation it is disliked and one should not do it. So where did they get the idea of that it's disliked or one should not do it? Why would they even come up with that idea? And why would it even be a discussion? The reason is because of a hadith narrated Abu Mash'ir, Najih al-Madani, al-Sundi. He narrated from Sa'id al-Muqbiri, sorry, who narrated from Abu Huraira that, and the hadith is in Sunan al-Bayhaqi, لا تقول رمضان, don't say Ramadan, فإن رمضان اسم من أسماء الله, it is a name from the names of Allah, ولكن قولوا, but rather say شهر رمضان. Rather say the month of Ramadan. So they stuck on that hadith. And that hadith, as I said, Imam al-Bayhaqi, he narrated in his Sunan al-Kubra. Ibn Adi, he narrated in his Kamil. And Ibn Adi weakened this hadith based on who? Abi Mish'ar. He weakened it because of him. And also Bayhaqi did. And also Imam al-Nawawi in his Majmu'. He said, هذا حديث ضعيف ضعفه البيهقي وغيره. He said, this hadith is weak. And it was weakened by Imam al-Bayhaqi. And he said, وَالضَّعْفُ فِيهِ بَيِّنٌ. And the weakness in it is very clear. And he said, the narrator I just mentioned, who it was in it, Abi Mish'ar, he said, وَهُوَ ضَعِيفٌ سَيُّ الْحِفْظِ. He is weak in his memory, and he's a weak individual. So if the hadith is not sahih, and the hadith is weak, then which opinion is going to be stronger? فَالصَّوَابُ الْقَوْلُ الْأَوَّلُ. The first opinion is stronger. وَأَنَّهُ لَا كَرَاهَةَ فِي قَوْلِ رَمَضَانَ مُطْلَقًا. وَاللَّهُ تَعَالَى أَعْلَمُ. And that is not disliked to say Ramadan unrestrictedly. You can say how you wish. Wallahu ta'ala a'lam, and Allah knows best. The third fiqh that we take from this hadith is what is the ruling in fasting before Ramadan? before Ramadan, if you fast more than 2 days before it. What is the ruling? If one wants to fast more than 2 days before Ramadan, he wants to fast. What is the ruling?